Hello friends, in this video we will learn about universal motor. A universal motor is defined as a motor which may be operated either on DC supply or a single phase AC supply at approximately the same speed and output. In fact, a universal motor is a smaller version of an AC series motor, about 5 to 150 watt of the rating. As it is a series wound motor, it has high starting torque and a variable speed characteristic. It runs at dangerously high speed on no load, and that is why such motors are usually built into the device they drive, so that there is no operation with no load. Now first, let us understand certain basics of an AC series motor, because a universal motor is nothing but an AC series motor. If an ordinary DC series motor were connected to an AC supply, it will rotate and exert unidirectional torque, because the current flowing both in the armature and field reverses at the same time. However, torque developed is not of constant magnitude as in DC series motor, but it pulsates between zero and maximum value in each half cycle. When the current reaches the maximum value in positive half cycle, torque will be at maximum value. When the current reaches at zero value, torque will be zero. So torque is pulsating torque. The performance of such motor will not be satisfactory because of the reasons explained here. The first is that the alternating flux would cause excessive eddy current loss in the yoke and field cores, which will become extremely heated. Vicious sparking will occur at the brushes because of the huge voltage and current induced in the short-circuited armature coils during their commutation period, because current will be induced by transformer action as we are supplying alternating current. Power factor is also low because of the high inductance of the field and armature circuits. However, by proper modification of design and other refinements, a satisfactory single phase motor can be produced. The eddy current loss can be reduced by laminating the entire iron structure of the field cores and yoke. All the volume of the iron which we are using, which will be acting as a path for the flux, is constructed with laminated sheets, so that eddy current loss is reduced. Power factor improvement is possible only by reducing the magnitude of the reactances of the field and armature windings. Field reactance is reduced by reducing the number of turns on the field winding. For any given current, it will reduce the field MMF, which will result in reduced air gap flux. This will tend to increase the speed, but it will reduce the motor torque. To obtain the same torque, it will now be necessary to increase the number of armature turns proportionally. Now let us understand the operation of a universal motor or an AC series motor. As you can see here, there is field winding which is connected in series with the armature winding. Let us consider this as a positive half cycle of the alternating current. Then the current flows as indicated in this diagram through the field winding and the armature in series. And so the armature current induced is in such a direction that the motor will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. The direction of the current induced in the armature conductor is as indicated by dot and cross notations over here. Now, in the negative half cycle, the direction of the current will be reversed as seen in this diagram. Now, as you can see, the direction of the EMF induced in the armature and thus the direction of the current induced in the rotor conductor bars is as shown in this diagram. So this direction of induced current also reverses compared to this situation, and so now the direction of the armature will also field and current will also be reversed, and thus the direction of the torque will remain the same as both the fields are reversing for the armature and field, and so the torque will be in counterclockwise direction, and so in negative half cycle also the motor will rotate in anti-clockwise or counterclockwise direction. So in both positive and negative half cycle the motor develops a unidirectional torque. Torque will be in the same direction, and so it can operate in AC supply as well as DC supply also. Now let us see the speed and load characteristic of universal motor. The speed of a universal motor varies just like that of a DC series motor. That is, at very low, at full load it is low, and very high at no load, about 20,000 rpm in some cases. In fact, on no load the speed is limited only by its own friction and windage load. Figure shows here the typical torque characteristic of a universal motor, both for DC as well as alternating current. Usually gear trains are used to reduce the actual load speeds to proper value as per the requirement of the application. The vertical line here indicates percentage full load speed, and the horizontal line indicates percentage full load torque. Now if we want to reverse the direction of rotation, then we may do it by reversing the flow of current through either the armature or field winding. Usually it is done by interchanging the leads on the brushes as shown here. If the motor is rotating in anti-clockwise direction and we want the rotation in clockwise direction, then what we do is that instead of giving supply from the first field winding to the top brush, we change this lead to the bottom brush and this lead from the top lead. So by changing the leads on the brush holders, we can easily change the direction of rotation of a universal motor. Let us see what are the applications of universal motor. Universal motors are used in vacuum cleaners where actual motor speed is the load speed. Other applications where motor speed is reduced by gear train are drink and food mixtures, as seen here in the diagram, portable drills and domestic sewing machines, and other such applications. Thank you for watching this video.